The silkworm Bombyx mori is a holometabolous insect having four different stages in its life cycle, namely egg, larva, pupa and adult or moth. Of the four different stages, only larva being the feeding stage, reared for the purpose of production of commercial cocoons for extraction of silk. The larval stage has 5 instars with 4 molds. The rearing of first 2 instars of silkworm forms the young age, that is chaki. But the third instar is also closer to the young age in its nutritional and environmental requirements. Therefore, young age rearing represents growing of larvae up to second or third molt. Rearing of grown up silkworms, that is 4th and 5th instars, is termed as late age rearing. The young age silkworm rearing is a vital aspect of sericulture industry for the development of healthy larvae and harvesting the cocoon crop successfully. The success of young age rearing depends on the level of understanding of the requirements of silkworms and manipulation of their nutritional and environmental conditions to obtain maximum growth and robustness. Young age silkworms need more care and attention as their resistance to diseases is low, but they are relatively more resistant to high temperature, high humidity and bad ventilation. Cool and low humidity conditions are bad for the larvae throughout the growing stage, as these conditions are injurious to health of the larvae, leading to production of inferior quality cocoons. Rearing of late age silkworms is an easy task as compared to young age. However, proper care in providing good quality mulberry leaves in sufficient quantity and maintenance of hygienic conditions are of utmost importance to exploit the potential of a particular breed and to get good quality of cocoons. During this stage, larvae need comparatively low temperature and humidity and are a voracious feeding stage. As a result of increased consumption of leaf, the worms develop silk gland and secrete silk, apart from storing the energy for metamorphosis into mass via the pupal stage. Late age rearing, especially 5th instar, needs more labor and attention to harvest good quality cocoons, failing which all the activities get upset, leading to poor yield. Most of the developed and developing countries are facing labor problem. Sericultural practices in these countries have started diminishing year after year. Labor requirement in late age rearing, especially 5th age, is about 50% of the total man days required. Hence, efforts are being made to reduce the labor input and to maximize the cocoon yield. To know more about the silkworm rearing methods, the topic has been divided into different subheadings, and they are: number 1, characteristic features of young age silkworms; number 2, characteristic features of late age silkworms; number 3, young age silkworm rearing methods; number 4, late age silkworm rearing methods. Young age silkworms, particularly those in the first instar, have a high growth rate. During first instar, body weight increases by 10 to 15 times, whereas in other instars, the weight increases by 5 to 6 times only. Similarly, per unit body weight, the amount of food supplied, oxygen intake and evaporation are largest in the first instar. Young age silkworms shows resistance against high temperature and humidity than grown up silkworms. Therefore, rearing them slightly at high temperature and humidity results in higher silk productivity. Young age silkworms are less resistant to pathogenic microorganisms than grown up silkworms, and therefore rearing of engaged silkworms under hygienic condition has great impact on the stabilization of cocoon crop. Engaged silkworms are weak against carbonic acid, ammonia, muscardine, etc. If the concentration of carbon dioxide gas in rearing room or in rearing box exceeds 2%, the growth of silkworms is retarded. If temperature rises to 30 degree centigrade or higher, viral diseases may be liable to occur. In newly hatched larvae, water content is very low but increases rapidly up to second instar when feeding starts. Engaged silkworms require high water content in mulberry leaves to supply the water requirement in their body. Silkworms attain maximum growth during late age, representing more than 94% of the leaf consumption, 133 times increase in body size, 125 times increase in body weight, and nearly 1000 times increase in silk gland weight. They have less resistance to high temperature and humidity, poor ventilation, and other environmental conditions. The amount of mulberry leaf ingested and digested greatly increases, and they consume coarser and somewhat wilted leaves. But the ingestion to digestion ratio is lower than that of engaged silkworms. They can withstand on reduced amount of mulberry leaves, but such conditions affect the quality of cocoons to a considerable degree. They are comparatively more resistant to chemicals. There are different methods of engaged silkworm rearing which are in practice. All the methods aim at preventing dryage of mulberry leaves fed to the silkworms and to maintain proper temperature and humidity in the rearing bed. In all the cases, paraffin paper is used as both seat and cover. Wet foam pads are used all round the bed to increase the humidity. But use of foam pads without proper disinfection can lead to contamination and spread of diseases. Hence, instead of wet foam pads, use of wet folded old newspaper, which can be discarded after each rearing, is more ideal when humidity is below 50%. An alternate method of rearing without using foam pads is the tutsumi iku or wrap up rearing, where the paraffin paper is used as seat and cover for the chalky bed and folded from all sides. Wrap up rearing is done only during the first 2 instars when the humidity is in the range of 50 to 70%, and is possible to increase the bed humidity by another 20 to 30%. At the time of feeding, the rearing bed is kept open for 30 minutes for gaseous exchange. Wrap up rearing helps in reducing the drying of chopped mulberry leaves and to maintain the bed humidity at a level to facilitate retention of leaf moisture content. The methods of rearing engaged silkworms are as follows. Farmer's method of rearing. It is an unscientific method of rearing engaged silkworms, as the farmers do not use wooden trays, paraffin paper or wet foam pads. The newly hatched larvae are brushed directly on the cow dung smeared bamboo trays. As a result, the optimum micro environmental conditions cannot be maintained in rearing tray, leading to quick drying up of mulberry leaves provided for feeding. In order to tide over the situation, the farmers resort to increase the frequency of feeding, that is 6 to 8 feedings as against 2 to 3 feedings per day with the recommended method. This is not only leads to wastage of leaf, but also increases the labor on the part of the farmers. As the method proves to be unscientific and crop losses are common, as the cow dung smeared bamboo trays serves as a storehouse for many pathogenic microorganisms which cause diseases in silkworms. Stand method of rearing. This method is followed when optimum temperature and humidity are available or temperature is high in the rearing house. Engage rearing is done in trays as practiced for late age rearing. Paraffin paper is used as seed cover for engaged silkworms. Stand rearing is not suited for large scale rearing as it requires more space for rearing. Besides, this method is laborious as the mulberry leaves are harvested individually for feeding the silkworms. Paraffin paper method of rearing. This method is also known as covered rearing method. In this method, paraffin paper is used at the bottom as well as on the top of rearing trays to cover it. The objective of covering rearing trays with paraffin paper is to ensure optimum humidity in the bed and to keep mulberry leaves fresh for a longer period to ensure full nourishment and uniform development. The paraffin paper used for covering the rearing bed should be new and of good quality without the smell of petroleum, and melting point of the paraffin paper must be above 50 degrees centigrade. During the first 2 instars, the rearing bed should be covered at both top and the bottom with the 4 sides wrapped, and before covering the bed with paraffin paper at the top of the rearing bed. Wet foam pads on all the 4 sides of rearing bed are placed to maintain required humidity. While for 3rd instar, paraffin paper is used only as a cover for the rearing bed, and wet newspaper and other materials used for increasing humidity should be removed. The cover should be taken away about 30 minutes before feeding to admit fresh air and to dispel accumulated toxic gases. It is desirable to maintain space between the paraffin paper cover and the rearing bed. Further, the top covering should be removed at molting stage to dry the rearing bed. In this type of rearing, particularly in humid places, there is a fear of incidence of muscardine disease. To prevent this, prophylactic measures should be taken at each molt and in the middle of each instar. Box method of rearing. This method is practiced when the temperature and humidity are lower. The boxes are made up of wood or plastic trays of 4 feet by 3 feet by 4 feet or 3 feet by 2 feet by 4 feet are used for rearing. The boxes used may be with or without lid. Rearing in boxes with lids. In this, rearing bed is prepared as in the paraffin paper method, and the lid is placed on the box, which is later arranged on the rearing stand. In this case, for rearing 13 star larvae, the boxes are not covered with lids. When the worms start settling for molt, paraffin paper, wet foam pads and the lids of the boxes are removed to keep the beds dry. Rearing in boxes without lids. In this case also, the rearing beds are prepared as in paraffin paper method of rearing. The boxes are piled one on top of another for rearing 1st and 2nd instar larvae. For rearing 3rd instar larvae, a space of 2 to 3 cm is provided between each 2 boxes by keeping wooden strips for ventilation. The boxes are kept open for at least 30 minutes prior to each feeding and completely when the larvae start settling for molt. In this method also, chances of incidence of muscardine are quite high, and hence prophylactic measures should be exercised to contain the disease. Hot chamber method of rearing. This method is widely adopted by Chinese sericulturists for rearing engaged silkworms. With this method, over 30% labor and about 25 to 35% leaves could be saved. This method has the advantage in maintaining uniform temperature, humidity and freshness of leaves, high leaf utilization ratio, less frequency of feeding, uniform and fast larval development owing to high temperature and humidity existing in it. The chamber should be thoroughly sterilized before rearing. Blue polythene sheet method of rearing. To maintain optimum humidity conditions, use of paraffin paper, wet foam pads and box rearing are popular in tropical conditions. Because of the natural wear and tear, high cost and non-availability of paraffin paper, use of blue polythene sheet is found more advantageous. It is used in silkworm beds in place of paraffin paper for bottom cover. The polythene sheet should be of 400 gauge. During high humid conditions, wet foam pad and bottom sheet can be dispensed with. About 3-inch gap should be maintained in between covering sheets and rearing bed. Further, pinhole perforations should be made at the rate of 1 hole per centimeter square on the upper polythene sheet. Advantages of using blue polythene sheet. Polythene sheets are easily available. Polythene sheets can be washed and disinfected. Polythene sheets are much cheaper and durable than paraffin paper. Isolation chamber method of rearing. Isolation chamber has been developed to provide better environmental conditions and hygiene at the farmer's level with low input cost, as most of the farmers are conducting silkworm rearing in dwelling houses. The isolation chamber is useful when temperature and humidity are very low. The chamber is made of plywood sheets with wooden frame of 6 feet height, 4 feet width and 5 feet depth, with a single front door measuring 5.5 feet height by 4 feet width, having a glass window of 6 inch by 9 inch. Two bottom, that is 4 inch by 9 inch, and top ventilators, that is 9 inch diameter with sliding doors for air regulation, are provided along with heater and humidifier inside. It is possible to maintain optimum temperature and humidity by providing thermostat and humidistat. Rearing is done inside the chamber by piling up the trays on a chalky stand or on a small rearing stand. Rearing is done using paraffin paper as a seat and cover, or by wrapping with paraffin paper. Maintenance of temperature and humidity is easy inside the chamber because of the restricted area. The chamber is also provided with ventilators on the upper and lower side, through which aeration inside the chamber is achieved. A chamber of 6 feet by 4 feet by 5 feet can accommodate 300 disease-free layings till second molt. Advantages: optimum temperature and humidity can be effectively maintained with minimum fluctuations. Moisture loss in the mulberry leaf is minimized. Larval growth and molting behavior is uniform. Larval weight increases with reduction in larval duration. Effective rate of rearing and crop stability improves. Chances of contamination with dust and pathogens minimized. The rearing of late-age silkworms, that is 4th and 5th instars, is conducted by various methods, and farmers adopt the methodology suitable to the space available for rearing infrastructure and economic condition. Thus, the silkworm rearing can be of 3 different types. Tray or shelf rearing. In this method, late-age silkworms are reared in bamboo or wooden trays, which are arranged one over the other in tiers on rearing stands. Generally, the rearing stands are arranged in two rows on either side of the rearing hall, with adequate working space in the center for feeding and bed cleaning. Each rearing stand can accommodate 10 to 12 trays. Under this method of rearing, generally leaves picked individually from mulberry plantation are cut to convenient size and fed to the silkworms. Usually, 4 feedings are given in a day. Nets are used for cleaning rearing beds, as cleaning is practiced more frequently and also trays removed from the stand for every feeding. Labor requirement is high in this. However, this method has the advantage of accommodating more silkworms in a limited area than shoot feeding and is preferred by the rearers, those who are having rearing space limitation. Floor rearing. This method is adopted for late-age rearing by leaf feeding or shoot feeding. If farmers have enough space for rearing and can maintain hygienic conditions, rearing on floor can be conducted. 2 or 3 beds can be prepared with 1 to 1.5 meter width and length depending upon the space available, that is 5 to 7 meter in the rearing house, leaving about 0.6 to 0.8 meter space between the beds and from the margin to attend the feeding work. Shoot feeding is practiced in most cases, as cleaning is not done in this method of feeding, which is an added advantage for maintaining hygienic conditions and is also economical and time and labor saving method. This method of rearing is popular among farmers in Japan and northern region of China. Shoot rearing. In this method of rearing, the rearing racks are usually of 5 feet width and 35 feet length. This accommodates 20,000 larvae, that is 50 disease free layings, up to spinning. The shelves should be provided with 6 inch border to prevent the fall of larvae and for effective utilization of shelf area. Such shelves can be arranged in 3 to 4 tiers with a gap of about 30 inch in between. The rack can be constructed using wood, bamboo or mild steel. Using nylon mesh or fishing net supported by old newspapers as rearing seat of the shelf is proposed. The cost of shoot feeding rack made of wood, eucalyptus, poles, GI wire and nylon net to rear 150 DFLs is around rupees 3000. Entire shoots are harvested from the mulberry garden and fed to the silkworms. As the leaf supply due to shoot feeding is distributed in 3 dimensions, it creates better scope for aeration in the bed besides accommodating 50% more silkworms per unit area of rearing bed as compared to the shelf rearing. In this method, bed cleaning is practiced once each during 4th and 5th instar or only in 5th instar on second day, and the cocoon yield by such practice is higher, which is 70 to 80 kilograms per 100 disease free layings. In shoot rearing, feeding is done 2 or 3 times per day according to the season. Advantages of shoot rearing: better keeping quality of leaf during storing and in the rearing bed. Handling of the silkworms during rearing is minimum. Leaves and larvae do not come in contact with litter. Hence, chances of contamination and spreading of diseases are reduced. Better aeration in the rearing bed is ensured and growth of worms is uniform. Leaf and labor saving up to 15 and 50% respectively when compared to leaf feeding method. Bed area requirement is less, that is 15 to 20% as compared to tray or shelf rearing. Cocoon characters and effective rate of rearing are comparatively superior over leaf feeding method. Requires more floor area, that is about 30% as compared to tray or shelf rearing. Bed refuse will not be available as cattle feed. Planting materials, that is cuttings, will not be available for new plantation. The topic on silkworm rearing methods can be summarized that growth stages of silkworms can be divided into young age and late age based on the requirements with respect to environmental and nutritional parameters and similarly with their characteristic features. Though young and late age silkworms can be reared by adopting different methods, rearing of young age silkworms with wrap up or isolation method and late age silkworms with shoot rearing were found better over other methods of rearing silkworms for recording higher cocoon yield together with quality.